Hello there, boys and girls. It is I, Blame Truth, and I'm bringing you some new gameplay on the new maps, with the new gun, with the new DLC, with my new underwear. I'm sitting here in my new underwear. I'm not lying about that. I got new underwear on, and I'm doing this commentary in them because I can. So this is Revolution DLC. Now, this DLC contains 4 multiplayer maps, new zombies map, I think a new zombies mode, I'm not entirely sure on that, as well as a new weapon for the first time ever, new weapon DLC in the new Call of Duty. And this is actually my very first game using this weapon, playing on this map, whatever, and I actually drop a VSAT and a Warthog, which is pretty cool. I didn't expect that. Maybe it was because I was using like 5 perks and hardline or whatever, but you know, I was pretty surprised at myself, especially considering I wasn't doing too hot on this game last night, and then I drop a freaking VSAT and Warthog this game. And but yeah, anyway, what I think of the maps and the gun and all that so far, I've only played 2 of the maps. I played Hydro and Private Match against Bots. That's a really cool map right there, and this map is very unique as well. I've never seen like a skate park map in a first-person shooter to my knowledge, or any shooter to my knowledge. And it's pretty interesting, I gotta say. It definitely flows pretty well too. These maps are pretty darn good so far from what I played. I haven't played the other 2, but Hydro and this map, I give a thumb up the butt. And yeah, as for the gun here, the Peacekeeper SMG, it's a weird little gun. Kind of reminds me of the SMG version of the SCAR in the assault rifle tier, where it has a little bit of recoil, but it has really long range. The fire rate's not that good either. It might even fire slower than like the MSMC and the PDW and all that. But the selling point of this weapon is probably not going to be its fire rate, but instead its range. It's going to have, I would imagine, the longest range out of any of the SMGs. And I like how I call in a VSAT right as they call in a counter UAV, but thankfully my teammate isn't a mouth breather and destroys it. I don't have anything to shoot that counter UAV down, so I was trying to shoot it with my gun, and end up getting some good VSAT assists. I don't really know this map that well. I'll probably still die with the VSAT up, so I'm just going to call in this care package here and let my teammates, you know, get me some VSAT assist points and hope this care package is pretty good. But lo and behold, they spawn right on top of me. And that's pretty cool though, because it enables me to kill this guy and get my Warthog, and that is a first game Warthog, first time playing this map Warthog. Pretty cool. Pretty proud of that. Anyway, I also got an RCXD, because we all know that the RCXD is all powerful, unless they have this perk on right here, because I can shove this thing right up their butthole and it still won't kill them. Look at that, old flak jacket, man. old flak jacket, but no worries, I'm gonna go behind these guys and kill them. But overall, you know, I think this is a pretty cool little DLC. It's definitely a much better deal than the fucking Modern Warfare 2 DLC back in the day, where they would release just like 5 maps, 2 of which were rehashed, and charge $15 for it. That was ridiculous. But here you get 4 maps, you get new zombies map, new zombies mode where you can play as the zombie. I think that's what it is. Correct me if I'm wrong there. And you get a new gun. So for that, I have to give this a thumbs up. This is a pretty cool little DLC. Of the 2 maps I played, I enjoyed them. I imagine the other 2 are pretty cool too, from what I've heard. Really, I think these maps are more of like Treyarch being experimental with how they make the maps, like, or the settings, I should say, the settings and the hazards of the maps and stuff. Like, this map in particular is pretty unique, and then there's that Hydro map, which takes place on a dam, and there's like a flood halfway through it, which will kill you. Don't underestimate the flood. And it's pretty cool. Pretty cool little DLC here. And personally, I would recommend it. But anyway, guys, I'm gonna cut the rest of this gameplay out because it's not really that exciting. And if you enjoyed the video, please leave it a like rating. You know, I recommend the DLC if you have 15 bucks to spare. You play a lot of Black Ops 2. I'm Prestige Master, have no life, so I play a lot of Black Ops 2. That's just how I roll. But anyway, guys, if you enjoyed the video, please rate it, comment it, subscribe, like it, all that mess, and I will see you guys later. Peace out.